ओके तो ऑलराइट, सो लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन। So today we will be starting with actuators. Okay, so that is a second module for this subject. So where we will discuss different type of actuators. Okay, what are the different actuator we can use in a mechatronic system? Okay. So before going into the detail of the type of actuator we are using, mechanism, principles, or any circuit diagram, we have to understand what first our actuator means. So coming back to the mechatronic systems, so systems, a mechatronic system basically consists of four major component. Okay, so four major, so don't confuse it with mechatronic system design. That is a design approach for a mechatronic system. Here we are talking about any mechatronic system, whether it's a robot, whether it's a servo, whether it's a servo motor, whether it's a AGV, automated guiding guided vehicle, like that. So any of this system will consist of four major component. First is your sensor, then you have actuators, third is your controller, okay, and fourth is your mechanical components. So let's say you have a mechatronic system. Okay, let's say we are taking example of AGV. So AGV will work, the function of AGV is to automatically guide the vehicle, and it will work on certain parameter, and it will consider certain variables, and this, after getting some input parameters by considering certain variables, it will transfer signal to a device called sensor, and the function of sensor is to sense the signals, and this signals will be sent for to the control unit. Okay, we have a controller, which is nowadays our mechatronic system consists of microprocessor or microcontroller. So this signal will be sent to the controller, where this signal will be processed, and it will transfer to the, in terms of a command signal, to a mechanical system, which will be having an actuator which is parallelly working. So this actuator will sense the signal, okay, and result in the actuation. So your actuation will occur, and AGV will perform the desired function. Okay, so coming back to this terms, actuator and actuation. So basically, if you consider your actuation, so basically you are converting energy, okay, to your mechanical energy, because in order, once the actuator will actuate, it will transfer the it will produce the mechanical forces or energy, enough mechanical energy, which will be transferred to any mechanical component, which may be a gear, belt chain mechanism, pulley, okay, and it will help to it will help the component to perform the desired work. Okay, so actuation is basically conversion of energy to a mechanical energy, and the device which perform this operation of what, conversion of energy into mechanical, is called your actuators. Okay, so basically the signal are coming in a form of maybe a digital or analog signal, and actuator will sense this signal and it will perform actuation, which is basically your energy conversion to mechanical energy, and the device which are used to perform this desired functions are your actuators. So one by one we will consider the different actuators. So first we have to understand the classification, actuator types and their applications. So the first system is your electromechanical. So electromechanical is a combination of electric plus mechanical. So what is happening here? The conversion of electric signal to mechanical energy. Okay, conversion of electric signal to mechanical energy. Then you have fluid power actuator. So it will convert the energy of fluid into mechanical energy. Okay, so fluid energy in terms of pressure will be there. And third, you have active material based actuators. So the material for which are used to design the actuator will get activated due to some physical interaction, and it will result in the actuation, basically conversion into a mechanical energy. So first, what is electromechanical actuator, which is basically converting electrical energy into mechanical energy. Then if you consider your electromechanical actuator, they work on the principle of magnetism. Okay, so you have Faraday's law, Fleming's law, like that. Okay, then what is happening here, this actuator is having certain magnets, so it utilizes magnets, may be permanent or electromagnet, to perform your actuation. Okay, so you have in this category DC motor, AC motor and stepper motor. We have some electrical systems like solenoid and relays also, but nowadays we are much more into this. These are basically used for controlling, or they are basically used for controlling the opening of valves on or cutting off the electrical signal. Okay, so basically they are used parallelly as an actuator or in controlling operation. Okay, next is your fluid power. So basically in this you have two types. One is pneumatic. So pneumatic basically utilizes air or pressurized or compressed air or inert gas. Then you have hydraulic. So you, for hydraulic you have oil and water, and major working principle is your Pascal's law. Okay, then how you are realizing the actuation, you have piston and cylinder assembly. So basically what is happening, you have cylinders. This is a simple diagram. So based on this delta P variation in the pressure, your piston will move, and this piston result in the movement of this rod, which will be connecting to the required system. Okay, in order to realize the actuation. Okay, so and the third one is your active material based. Okay, so in active material based, what is there? The material will undergo transformation. Okay, due to the physical interaction. Okay, material will go into transformation due to physical interaction. So physical interaction can be application of pressure, temperature or any other force that is that can be a magnetic force. So in this category you have piezoelectric material or piezoelectric ceramics are there. You have shape memory alloys and you have magneto destructive ceramics or device. Okay, anyone having idea about piezoelectric ceramic? Anyone? Any one of you can any idea about piezoelectric or shape memory alloy or magnetostructive ceramic or device? No one? Anyone having idea or I'll continue. So basically piezo means pressure. So with the application of pressure, electric field is generated or vice versa. Okay, so vice versa can happen. If you apply electric field, so pressure will be generated by change of length. So let's say you have a piezoelectric ceramic. So I am drawing in a form of a crystal. So when you are applying an electric field, its length will change. So your naturally occurring piezoelectric ceramic is quartz. Anyone having idea about quartz? You might have heard of quartz. Anyone?
No, sir.
Don't you use wristwatch? Anyone? So if you see your wristwatch, so in your wristwatch, okay, so initially what was there, let's say you have a brand name and at the bottom quartz is written. So basically quartz is used there. So what is happening here? You have your cell connected to this quartz and by the supply of electricity, this quartz will actuate. Its length will change. So due to the change in length, what is happening? You have gear system. If you will open your clock, so it is having a gear system for minute hand, second hand, and for hour hand. So all are connected. So when this length is changing, due to that actuation, this gear rotation will take place. So to do this change in length, this gear will rotate. So it will result in the movement of your second hand. Then the second hand gear is connected to minute hand and simultaneously hour hand. So this gear ratio is maintained, but in order to drive this gear, you utilize quartz. Okay. So if you have opened your wristwatch, so on the back side of it, you can see this gear panel. Okay. Likewise, the shape memory alloys are there. So this shape memory alloy basically the most majorly uses nitinol or nitinol. It is having nickel and titanium. So basically this alloy remember its shape. So that's why memory, this alloy is having memory to it can remember its shape. That's why the name is given shape memory alloy. Okay, so what is happening? You can see the video in YouTube. So if you will bend this shape memory alloy, let's in shape of your name, so let's say Kalyan, like this a name is written. Okay, and if you will put it inside a hot water, so temperature changes taking place, and due to this, let's say this wire, you are straightening up this wire at high temperature. Okay, but when you will take it out at room temperature, it will again goes back to that shape. So it is going back to this shape means it is memorizing its shape. Okay, so it has a mechanism why this is happening. So if you are interested, you can read it. Okay, there are Martin city transformation and all, so that is not relevant to this area. Likewise, you have magnetostructive devices. So magnetostructive, whenever kept inside a magnetic field, they will change their length. So as the change in length is taking place, so the actuation is realized. Okay, so we will go one by one to all these devices in coming classes. Today we'll start with your electromechanical. Electromechanical actuators. So in electromechanical actuator, what is happening? Conversion of electrical energy into mechanical energy, and they work in the principle of magnetism. So the basic principle of operation is when whenever you supply a current through a group of wires or a loop, okay, so due to which this magnetic field is generated, and due to generation of this magnetic field, this loop will tend to rotate, okay, and this rotation is transformed into mechanical energy, and it will be transferred to your shaft, which is connected to the required or which is connected to a desired system. Okay, so the detail of this actuation, how with the magnetic field this is rotating, we will see in when we will be going through DC motors. Okay, so these electromechanical devices, if you consider, they are very heavy weights. Okay, and but they can be used for a particular application for a prolonged duration of time. So if you have seen your CNC lathes and all, so in that you use motor, and that motors are working for a period of time, 20-30 years. Okay, so the first device we will study is your solenoids. Okay, you might have studied solenoid in your 12th. Okay, so basically solenoid is used for translating or conversion of on and off. Okay, so conversion of on and off of electrical signal to on and off of mechanical movement. Okay, so generally they are used to perform linear operation, linear actuation. Okay, so these comes under the category of linear actuators. Okay, so this comes under the category of linear actuator. So if you see the circuit diagram of solenoid, so you have coil, and inside the coil you have a plunger. Okay, so when current is supplied, okay, when current is supplied to this coil, so what will happen? Electromagnetic field will be generated, which will result in the motion of this plunger. So this operation is particularly used for the opening and closing of the valve. So if you see the cross section of your solenoid, so you have a base here, you have coils, okay, and you have a plunger here, okay, which is loaded by spring. Okay, so what will happen when current is applied to this coil? The magnetic field will be generated, and it will result in the movement of this plunger either in up direction or downward direction, and this plunger will be connected to the opening of control valve. So hence it will result in the transfer of fluid from one point to the another point. Okay, so basically they are used for the opening and closing of valve, and basically we use the valve for the controlling function. So what is happening when voltage is applied to the electric field? So magnetic field will be produced. Okay, this magnetic field will be produced in this frame. We have coil here, we have spring loaded system. Okay, this is your frame. So when electric field is applied to this coil, Okay, so electromagnetic field or magnetic field is produced in this frame, which will result in the actuation of this plunger. Okay, and it will result in the movement of plunger in up and down direction. Okay, then the second one is your electric relays. So basically, relay perform similar kind of actuation as that of solenoid. So on and off of electrical signal into on and off of mechanical signal. So if you see the circuit diagram of a relay, okay, so this is your coil. Okay, this is your coil and it is connected here. Okay, so this is your frame. So when electric current is supplied to this coil, so magnetic field will be generated and it will result in the up and down motion of this plunger. And once the plunger comes down, it will pull this switch. This is a relay switch. Okay, so which is fixed at one end and movable at another end. So when it is pushed downward, so it will result in the closing of this circuit. Okay, closing of this circuit. So when the circuit is closed, okay, so circuit is closed, then you consider it as a energized state of a relay. Okay, so when this circuit is closed, so it will allow the current to flow through it and you will have a motor or a generator connected at the end. So in order, it will control the on and off of this motor. Okay, and you are having electrical signal on and off here. You have electric on and off, which will result in this plunger movement, which is a mechanical actuation. Okay, now comes your majorly used actuators, which is your electric motor. So basically, electric motor receive electrical energy and they will produce a mechanical motion in form of a rotation, and this rotation motion is transferred to a system with the help of shaft and gear assembly. So you have three majorly used electric motors. One is DC motor, then you have AC motor, and you have stepper motor. So coming to your DC motor, DC motor is majorly used in heavy duty applications for controlling of conveyor belts and all. Okay, so if you consider the schematic of a DC motor, you have a rotor here, which is a rotating member. Okay, you have a stator here, which is a fixed member or static member. You have magnets, okay, here, permanent magnets. Okay, so you have south, north, then you can have north and south. Okay, so what is happening when current is applied to this rotor? So the rotor is having windings, okay, of coils. Okay, so when current is passed through this loop, electromagnetic force is generated and you have this permanent magnet. Okay, so you have this permanent magnet. So the direction of current I in the rotor and the magnetic field are in magnetic field of this stator, M magnetic field of this stator are in perpendicular direction, so due to which a force perpendicular to both of them, that is a Lorentz force, will be generated, and this Lorentz force will result in the rotation. Okay, this Lorentz force will result in the rotation of your rotating member, and once this rotation is achieved, it will be transferred to the system with the help of shaft and gear assembly. So basically, Lorentz force. Lorentz force is resulting in the rotation. So in this, you have a permanent magnet type DC motor, and you have electromagnetic type. Okay, so this is your permanent magnet type. Okay, you have a magnet inside of it. Okay. In coming to this electromagnetic type, okay, so you have two types, separately excited and self-excited. But before understanding this, first we have to understand how a electromagnetic motor, what are the component of a electromagnetic motor. So you have a stator windings, this is called as field winding. Then you have a rotor winding. Okay, so to both of this winding, current is supplied through the power source, and when this current is supplied through this winding, it will result in the generation of magnetic field, and this magnetic fields are opposes each other, which will result in the realization of rotation of the rotor. Okay, so this winding can be excited. Winding can be excited, or current can be supplied separately, so separately excited, or you have a self excited. So in separately excited, the current flow in the winding separately, so you have a separate power source. But in this one, self excited, the power source is common. Okay, the power source is common. Okay, so like that, you have AC motor which utilizes AC current. Okay, which utilizes your AC current. So that we will cover in next class. I think for today this much is, this dose is sufficient. Okay, so this is the previous. Yeah, so in this presentation I have this two question. Okay, you can go through this. Either you can write it in a soft or hard copy. For your reference, you can go through these questions. So as I told you, the actuator are used to produce action or motion. Okay, and they together with sensor and digital electronics are integrated into mechanical system, result in the development of your mechatronic system. Okay, it can be used for power amplification and modulation, or it can be used to convert the energy. Okay, so these are pneumatic. Yeah, so pneumatic we will cover. So this is your solenoid. So you can clearly see how the solenoid is working here. So when current is supplied, okay, when current is supplied to this coil, it will generate the magnetic field, and it will result in the motion of this plunger. So here you can see this plunger is acting as a control valve, and when it is lifted up, it will result in the fluid flow. Okay, next is your relay. So relay are basically electromechanical switch, as we have covered. Okay, so when push button is pressed, okay, this push button is pressed, so your coil, this relay get excited, and it will result in the closure of the circuit. Okay, so I think this animation is not working. Okay, then you have electrical actuators. Okay, electric actuators. In this, you have AC, DC, stepper, and servo motor. So how these are working? Okay, so this is a working schematic. So when current will be supplied through the coil, it will result in the electromagnetic field generation. Okay, and due to this electromagnetic field generation, you will have a Lorentz force which will result in the motion rotation of the rotor. Okay, so as we have covered that DC motor mostly used, okay, for heavy application purpose. So in you, as I told you, you have two. The assembly of a DC motor will look like this. It is having one rotating member, one stationary member, that is stator. Okay, and you have magnet. So this is a permanent magnet type DC motor. Okay, so in this, then in magnetic electromagnetic type, you have separately excited. Okay, and then you have self-excited. So in self-excited, you can have shunt and series machine. Okay, so you can go through that. It is not important, but you can study. You have to focus on the types. Okay, this is the example of shunt and series. So basically, you have coils are in parallel and series. So if you are interested, you can go through this, but this is not necessary. Okay. So AC motor basically utilizes AC current. So how AC motor works, okay, and what are the different types, that we will cover in our next class, that is on Wednesday. Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay, Amarnath. So can we end our class here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.